Autodesk recently posted a video on the modeling of a pencil sharpener. In this video, I want to draw your attention to the 25th minute mark where a press pull command was performed on the base in order to create a recess for the ring. This video is not meant to be a critique, but rather an alternative to the method that was presented. In fact, I learned a lot from that video, and I would highly encourage all of you to watch it. I'm going to do a quick run-through of the method presented and then present my alternative. This is not going to be an exact replica, but rather a simplified version of the model. Here, we have a cylinder split into three main bodies: top, middle, and base. Let's hide the top, since that will not be part of the discussion. The end result we are looking for is a ring based on the middle section, which will then be assembled onto the base. In the original video, a shell operation was performed on the midsection. Next, a recess had to be created on the base in order for the ring to slot through. Because of the way the cylinder was split in the first place, you can see that the base is missing a whole chunk of material on which we can use to cut the recess. To resolve that, the top surface of the base had to be extended through a press pull or an offset face in order to create the material for the recess to be created. This is not exactly an elegant solution. So here comes the alternative. Essentially, this whole workflow can be improved by simply copying bodies. At the beginning, instead of splitting the bodies into three sections, let's just split out the top section. Let's rename the body and hide it. At this point, you can think of this remaining volume as composed of the ring and the base merged into one single body. Let's rename the body accordingly. The most crucial step of this whole process is to create a copy of this body. Select the body from the bodies folder. Press Ctrl+C to copy and Ctrl+V to paste. At this point, the Move Copy window pops up. Just click OK to confirm. And a duplicate of the body will be created in the exact same location. An alternative is to right-click on the body, select Copy, and right-click in Space, and select Paste. If you try using the Move Copy command to do this, Fusion does not allow you to create a copy in the exact same location. Rename the copied body. Hide the original. We shall perform a split on the copy using the other sketch line. We shall use this section to make the ring. Rename this body. This section is not needed. Right click and remove. In this workflow, it is essential to rename the bodies diligently as it can get confusing pretty quickly. Next, perform a shell operation on the ring. Unhide the base. Go to Modify, Combine. Select the base as a target body. Select the ring as a tool body. For operation, select Cut. A recess in the shape of the ring will be cut onto the base. Since we want to retain the ring, we need to check the Keep Tools option.